Dear students, let us discuss experiment number 14 from C Programming Laboratory. The aim of this experiment is develop a program using pointers to compute the sum, mean and standard deviation of all elements stored in an array of n real numbers. Okay, so here you have to write a program using pointers, very important. Using pointers, you have to write a program to compute three things, that is sum, mean and standard deviation of all the elements stored in an array of n real numbers. You have to take an array of n real numbers, and from those n real numbers you have to find the sum, mean and standard deviation by using pointers. Okay, so before we go for writing a program for this, so let me discuss some basics regarding the standard deviation and the pointers. So in previous days you might have studied the concept of standard deviation in your PUCs or maybe in high schools. So the standard deviation, it's a mathematical construct. It is mainly used in the concept of statistics and all. So the formula for calculation of the standard deviation is given by, the standard deviation is denoted by this symbol sigma, and this is given by the formula square root of 1 divided by n summation of I equal to 1 to n xi minus mu whole square, where xi is an individual numbers, so whatever the n real numbers we have, so this xi represents the n real numbers where I value is from 1 to n, that is xi. Minus mu, mu is nothing but mean, mean or average of all the n numbers. Okay, and here to calculate the standard deviation, you have to calculate this one, that is summation of I equal to 1 to n xi minus mu whole square. That is, for every number you have to subtract mean, and you have to take the square of that, and you have to find the summation of all those values divided by n. So whatever this inner part we calculate, so this is called as the variance. Okay, and if you take the square root of this variance, that becomes the standard deviation. So that's why here we can write standard deviation is equal to square root of variance. So in this way we can calculate the standard deviation. Okay, so after this we'll discuss some basics of the pointers. So what is pointer? So already you know, pointer is a variable whose value is the address of another variable. Okay, so till now we saw the different variables. So we declare a variable to store a particular value, but the pointer is again a variable, but here it is not going to store the value, it is going to store the address of another variable. So this is something different. Okay, so the address of another variable means it is the direct address of the memory location, because we know that whenever you declare a particular variable, so some sort of memory is allocated for that, and whatever the address of that memory is there, so this will be stored into the pointer variable. So like any variable or constant, the pointer must also be declared before using in your program. So what is the syntax for declaring a pointer variable? So the syntax is similar to declaring a simple variable only. The only change is the star. Okay, so whenever you declare a simple variable, the syntax is data type followed by name of the variable. But whenever you are declaring a pointer variable, you have to precede that pointer variable name with star to indicate that the variable declared is a pointer variable. Okay, so this is the syntax for declaring a pointer variable. So after this we'll consider an example. So here in this example we have taken one variable, that is int var, a simple variable, and we initialize this with 10. Okay, so whenever you declare a variable like this, we know that a block of memory will be allocated for this variable. Okay, and this block is labeled with the name of the variable, that is var, and here you have assigned value 10 to this variable, means the value 10 is stored here. Okay, but whenever you declare a variable, whenever a memory block is allocated, so this memory block will be having some address. So here in our example the address is 00xbba77, so this is the address of this memory block. Okay, So this is simple variable. So after this we'll declare one pointer variable. Okay, so in the previous slide itself we saw whenever you declare a pointer variable, you have to precede the pointer variable name with star to indicate that the variable is a pointer variable. So here we write int star p, means this p is a pointer variable which can hold the address of another variable. Okay, so after this, so let us initialize the value of this pointer variable p. So we write p equal to ampersand var. Why ampersand var? Because if I just write var, so what is the value of var? 10. So 10 is assigned to p, but this p is not a simple variable, it is pointer variable, and you have to assign address of an variable. So to fetch the address of this variable var, we have to write ampersand var. When you write ampersand var, the address of var, what is the address of var? Address of var is this one, that is 00XBA77. So this will be assigned in place of p. So that's what you can see here. So when you declare a variable like int var, so for this particular block of memory is allocated, it is labeled with var, and the value 10 is stored here. So it is having some address. Similarly, whenever you declare a pointer variable also, so for this also a block of memory is allocated, it is also labeled with the name of that variable p, but whatever the value you are stored here, so that is stored here. So here we have stored indirect value, not the direct value. So indirect means your taking the address of this variable var, and this is stored in p. So address of var is this one, so this is stored here. Okay, so in along with this, this p, obviously a block of memory is allocated, so this will also be having address associated with this p also. Okay, so here when this p is holding the address of this variable, so we say this p is pointing to the variable this one, means this p is pointing to variable var, means here it is also possible to access or to change the value of this variable var through the pointer variable p. Okay, so here p is a pointer here which is pointing to the address of the variable var, and no data type for var and p should be same. So that is the condition, that's already you know. So here now let us see how exactly you can access the values of the pointer and the variable to which the pointer is pointing. So if you print the value of these three things, if you print the value of var, what it will print? The value of var, it will print, value of var, it will print 10. Okay, but if you print the value of p, what it will print? If you print the value of p, what is the value of p? P holds the address of this var, so this is displayed. Okay, but as I told you, through this pointer p, it is possible to modify or access the value of this variable to which it is pointing. How it is possible? So for this you have to use a separate operator, so that is called as a dereferencing operator, so that is denoted by star. Okay, so although star is used while declaring a variable, but after this, whenever in your program if you associate the star with the pointer variable, it will be replaced with the actual value of a variable to which this pointer is pointing. Okay, so that is what the difference between p and star p. P means the value of this variable p, whereas star p means the value of a variable to which this pointer p is pointing. So in this example, this p is pointing to variable var, so the value of that var is 10. So that's why star p will print the value 10. Okay, so with this basics, let us move on to the actual program now. Okay, so let us see how we have written a program for this. So already we saw the aim of this experiment. So the aim is develop a program using pointers to compute the sum, mean and standard deviation of all elements stored in an array of n real numbers. Okay, so here we have included these two header files, hashInclude.h, hashInclude.mat.h. After that, here we define one constant also, that is hashDefine max size, whose value is 10. So void main, the main function, and after that we have declared these two variables, that is float x of max size comma star p. Okay, so here x is an array variable of size max size, so we have, instead of defining a direct value here, we have defined a constant, and we'll be using this constant to indicate the maximum value. So if you want, you can write x of 10 also directly, this you can go with this. Okay, so here this x is an array which holds all the elements of which you want to find some mean and standard deviation. Okay, and along with this you have to calculate, you have declared one more pointer variable here, star p. So here the type of this pointer variable is star float means it can hold the address of a floating point variable. So after this we need two more local variables, that is I and n of type integer, and after this we declare some more variables to store the calculated values of type float, which is mean, variance, standard deviation, sum which is initialized to 0, and sum1 which is initialized to 0. Okay, so first we have to read the value of n to know how many elements the user want to enter. So it is printf enter the value of n, scanf percentage d and percent n. Okay, so once we know that n number of values, so we have to read those n number of values. So printf enter percentage d real numbers, so this percentage d is replaced with n, so if n is 5 it will display the message as enter 5 real numbers. Okay, so we have to read those in the array x by using this for I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus, scan a percentage f, I am percent x of. Okay, so this is the reading part. So after this now we have to start the calculation. So here as you can see you have to write a program using pointers, so you have to use pointers to calculate the values. So that's why here what we do is we have already declared a pointer p. Okay, so we initialize the value of p with the value of x. Okay, so this is similar to writing p equal to ampersand var in our example, previous example. Okay, but here if you have a simple variable you have to use ampersand, but if it is an array variable no need to use ampersand, the name of that array itself indicates the address of first element. So that's why here we initialize the pointer equal as p equal to x. Okay, so after this what we have to do, so for I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus, what we have to do is first we have to calculate the sum of all the numbers. Okay, so to calculate sum of all the numbers we have written here as sum equal to sum plus star p plus plus. Okay, so what is this sum? Sum is a variable which is initialized to 0. Okay, so we have to calculate the sum of all n numbers. Okay, so which starts with p equal to x. So as I told you this x is an array. Okay, and here when you write p of x, p equal to x means it is going to point, it is pointing to the first element of array. So similarly when you increment the value of p it will be pointing to the subsequent elements. Okay, so here p equal to x means it is pointing to the first element. So here sum equal to sum is initially 0, this is 0 plus, timing you don't consider plus plus, you just consider the star p. What is the star p? In our previous discussion itself we saw the star is nothing but a dereferencing operator. When you use star p it will be replaced with the actual variable's value to which this pointer is pointing. So here p is pointing to variable x. X is an array variable, so as I told you p equal to x means it is pointing to the first element of array x. Okay, so here star p means it will be replaced with the first element of array x. Okay, so as a result the first element of array x will be added to the value of sum. Sum is initially 0, so 0 plus first value, so the first value is stored in the variable sum. Okay, so after this here we have plus plus. Plus plus means it is post increment, so you might have studied this pre increment and post increment. Post increment means first the value of this is used and after that the value is incremented. So when we use star p, so after that p is incremented. So when p is incremented, so it indicates p is pointing to the second element of array x. Okay, so when p is pointing to the second element of array x, again it will go back, so I will be incremented by 1. So in the next time again the same line is executed. So this time sum is already holding the first element of array x, so it is equal to first element of array x equal to plus star p plus plus. Now p is pointing to the second element, so star p means it will return the second element of array x. So second element plus first element, so whatever the sum we get, so that is stored in sum. Okay, so after this again p is incremented by 1, so p will be pointing to the next element. Okay, so in this way this for loop will be iterated for n number of times. As a result this line will be executed m number of lines to calculate the sum of n numbers that are present in the array x. Okay, so after this whenever this for loop is completed the sum will hold the value of the sum of all the elements of array x. Okay, so after this you can easily calculate the mean value. So mean is equal to sum divided by n, but n is of type integer and sum is of type floating point here. So here we have to typecast explicitly. So for this means typecasting explicitly means here, if you don't use this also, automatically it is typecasted, but here we have used explicitly. So the sum is floating point, n is integer. So we convert this integer into float by using this explicit typecasting. So float of n. So sum divided by float of n. So it will give you the mean, and that is stored in the variable mean. Okay. So as per our formula, so here we have found this one, that is mu. Okay. So after this, we have to carry out this one now. So for that, here we have. Once again, we initialize p equal to x, the same line. So after that, we use this for loop, that is for I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. After that, again p plus plus. So each time when I is incremented, p is also incremented here, and p is again pointing to the first element of array x. Remember, once again we have initialized this p equal to x. Okay. So here what we do? So sum one. Again, what is sum one? Sum one is equal to 0. Again, a temporary variable. So sum1 equal to sum1 plus POW. What is this POW? This is a power function. Okay. So power of star P. What is star P? Star P means, again, this will be, this will give you the element of array X. So initially P equal to X means it is star P will give you the first element. When P is incremented, it will give you second element. Again, when P is incremented, it will give you third element, and so on up to n elements. Okay. So here it is like writing power. Power means it is raised to. So here star p minus mean, star p minus mean comma 2 means p minus mean whole square. So this is how we implement this formula. So it is xi minus mu whole square. So mu is here mean. So xi is the actual number, the number minus mean whole square. Okay. So this is represented here. That is, for I equal to 0 to n, so power of star p minus mean comma. Okay, so we have to take the summation of this. So summation from I equal to 1 to n. So that's why here, to implement that summation, we use this, that is sum 1 equal to power of star p minus mean comma 2. This is in the for loop. Means here, for n number of times, this line will be executed, and as a result, the final value will be stored in this variable sum 1. Okay, so in sum 1, which value we are storing? So we have found this value, and this value is present in the variable sum 1. So now what we have to do to find the variance, this value should be divided by n. So we will get variance, and to that value, if you take square root, you will get the standard deviation. Okay. So here, so you got the sum 1. So after that sum 1, what you have to do? You have to divide this value of sum 1 by the value of n. Again, by using explicit typecasting, you will get variance. Okay. So once you get the variance, to calculate the standard deviation, you just take the square root of that variance. Okay. As per this particular formula. Okay. So what all things we did? So first we found the mean, that is mu. So it is the summation of all the elements. So once we found the summation of all the elements, so we have used the for loop to execute n number of times, and each time we have taken xi minus mu whole square by using this power function, that is power of star p minus mean comma 2. Okay. So once it finds the value of that sum 1, so if you divide that with n, you will get variance, and if you take the square root of variance, you will get the standard deviation. So in this way, you can calculate these corresponding values by using the pointers. Okay. So after this, we have to just display the values. So we'll display these three values. So printf mean of all elements equal to percentage. Instead of writing just a percentage f, we are using percentage dot 2f. What is the significance of this dot 2? Dot 2 means, this indicates after this decimal point, I want to display only two digits. So that's why dot 2f. If you don't want to use this, you can just use percentage f. If you just use percentage f, it will display six digits after the decimal point default. Okay, so that's why to restrict the number of digits after decimal point to 2, we use dot 2f. Okay, if you want, you can try to execute without using this dot 2 also. You can you will get the difference. Okay, without using dot 2, if you just write percentage f, it will display 6 digits after the decimal point. But if you use dot 2, it will display only 2 digits after the decimal point. Okay, so here it will display the value of the variable mean. So after that, in the next printf, we display variance of all elements equal to, again, percentage 2f. It is present in the variable variance. So after that, standard deviation equal to percentage 0.2f, it is present in the standard deviation. Okay, so in this way you can write a program using pointers to calculate the sum, mean and standard deviation of all the elements that are present in the array or the real elements. Okay, so this is how you can write a program. So hope all of you understood this. Still, if you have any doubt or confusion, so please feel free to discuss with me. So now we'll execute this particular program. So before execution, we have to compile this. So it takes some time. So when there is no error, so you can go for execution. So when you run this program, so it is going to ask the value of n, that is the number of elements. So here I'll take the number of elements as 5. So it is asking to enter 5 real elements. So I will take the first 5 elements, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So from this 5, it has calculated all the 3 values. The mean of all elements is equal to 3, variance of all elements equal to 2, and standard deviation equal to 1.41. So whatever the formula we saw, so by using this formula, you just try to calculate the values and you will get the correct values like this. Okay. So in this way, you can write a program to calculate the standard deviation, mean and sum of all the real numbers that are stored in the array of size m. Thank you.